Dudes, we're back. Shout out, open-minded people.
Open-minded, shout out.
We're back with a classic.
Run DMC. Classic group, anyway. Run DMC.
DMC. Evolutionary song.
Man, you went gangster there for a second.
And this shit came out.
I was
worried. People were like, what the hell is this? Because nothing sounded like it in 1983 and 4 and shit.
Wait, what was wrong
with
it?
In the studio, Russell Simmons, like, when they finished it, everyone's like, all right, tomorrow we're going to add bass. We're going to add guitar to it. He's like, no, it's done. He's like, what do you mean it's done? He's like, we're not fucking with no guitar or bass. It's done. Like, what are you going to do with it?
I mean, it's just a drum track?
It's basically just the fucking, like, an 808 drum machine type shit.
Huh.
With some scuff over it or some shit, like some kind of slap. But when this shit came out, no one heard this shit like this. Everything was instrumentation
and
to the fullest.
And with their, distinct delivery to the music, like,
so
you know,
good.
When, I mean, even I know Run DMC.
Jam Master Jay is cutting this up, man. It's legendary.
So,
yeah. Everyone knows.
This is going to be pretty cool.
They're the Beatles of hip hop.
Yeah.
Considered the Beatles of hip hop.
Yeah, that
makes sense. Because they broke so many barriers down back in the early 80s that there was no other hip hop group that was on that level, you know.
Huh.
That's it. Maybe a little change up here and there, but
2 years ago, a
friend
of mine asked me to say some MC rhyme, so I said the rhyme I'm about to say. The rhyme was there, but then it went this way. Took a test to become an MC, and our friend became amazed at me. So Larry put me inside, stacked the light. The strip was thrown off, and we never came back. They cut the record down to the bone, and now they got me rocking on the microphone. And then we talked. Nothing in the world that run the level like a cold chill at a party in a b-boy stand. And rock on the mic and make the girls wanna dance. Fly like a dove, pick up them up above. I'm rocking on the mic, it's called the Russ Love.
Wow.
I got a big long cat and I'm like a Seville. And written right on the side and read just the kill. So if you see me choosing girls, then move a step aside. There ain't enough room to fit you all. First come, first serve basis. Pulling out, girl, take you to a death place. One of a kind, and for your people to light, and for your sucker MC. This ain't right, because you're fighting on your life. You're cheating on your wife. You're walking around town like a woman with a knife. You're hanging on the ass, you're chilling with the crew. And everybody knows what you've been through. I'm with the 1, 2, 3, 3 to 2, 1. My man Larry Lamb, my name's DJ Run. We do it in the place with the highs and the bass. I'm rocking to the rhythm, want to watch it go.
DMC are both rap, but Rev Run was a well-known DJ even in the 70s, I guess. He was Curtis Blow's DJ. You've heard of Curtis Blow. He was like one of the first.
I think there's a song dedicated to Curtis Blow, right?
Guys,
Curtis Blow. That's a song. It's like a Lynyrd Skynyrd tune, right?
Could be.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure.
No, but he was like one of the very first kind of like popular solo artists in the late 70s, early 80s. Curtis Blow. Rev Run used to DJ for him, but I was waiting. I was waiting, like, because he...
Well, yeah,
Rev
I was,
Run,
too. I'm looking at the
Rev Run just wrapped the whole shit. Jesus. You know? I'm like, when is DMC coming in?
There's like 30 seconds left.
I never sat down and listened to this. I've heard the beat. I never heard like the whole beat though, like the switch ups and the
honestly, it was like changes. A deer in headlights in the beginning. I'm just like,
shit's crazy.
I never heard anything like this.
This shit came out almost 40 years ago, and it still sounds crisp.
Beastie Boys have tried to capture this song, and
they toured with them.
Back then. It makes sense. I believe
they did License to Ill. I know they toured together at one point. I'm not sure what album Beasties were on, but I think License to Ill was their first LP or whatever. Shout out,
Run
DMC.
Have you ever watched them jam live? Like, I mean, I saw the
Beastie Boys when they're on their instruments.
Anthrax.
The punk rock thing.
No, Run DMC.
Oh,
not like live and live, but like. Watched a video of them live?
No.
Or like the music video, the Anthrax one, or no, it's Aerosmith.
Oh, we did that. But
they were kind of like live.
Yeah.
I think it was studio, but
I think it was more studio than
a live vibe.
Yeah, they were like at a concert in it.
Yeah.
We did a live reaction to that. You're thinking of Public Enemy and Anthrax, Bring the Noise. I don't know. We might have.
My bad.
Peace! That's fucking legendary shit.
I always say it's Run DMC, and you're like, what are you talking about? Oh, Jesus. Public Enemy.
Yeah, no, it's legendary. Classic.
Yeah. Awesome.
Everyone was inspired. I've heard of Rock Him being, he was inspired by Run DMC.
You could tell, yeah.
When he heard this shit back then.
Because they're given hardcore delivery lyrics, but like not
good
that
ass
nasty punch to.
Yeah, they're both great MCs
too.
You know,
just matter of fact, saying truth.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah,
it's awesome.
Peace, awesome everyone. Till next time. One.